everybody. I'm Laura Trump coming to you from Studio 45 at Trump Tower in New York City. Impeachment is a solemn power granted by the people through the U.S. Constitution. But regardless of the facts, the Democrats are on a collision course with history. Joining me is a former member of Congress, Dr. Nan Hayworth. Nan, thank you for joining us again. Fun fact fun fact for our audience, you were our first guest on our Real News here. This is so exciting to have you.
Well, it's an absolute privilege to have been able to be your first guest and to be here with you today.
Well, thank you. We love having you. And listen, as a former member of Congress, we have to get your thoughts on the complete circus that we see going on Capitol Hill right now. What are your thoughts about everything? Because the Democrats are using something that was put in the U.S. Constitution for a reason, but they're using it for a political purpose. And I think people are seeing that. What are your thoughts on things?
They're definitely seeing it, Laura, and you're right. The Constitution defines impeachment in a particular way as really the gravest action that the House of Representatives can take to check the power of the executive branch.
Yeah.
And in this case, it's absolutely crystal clear that there is no basis in fact for doing this.
Yeah.
And this is purely a political process. And they have indeed weaponized this because they want to negate the results of an election that didn't go their way.
Yep.
And it's a terrible disservice to the American public. It is entirely a political process. There is nothing justified constitutionally about this. And as a former member of Congress, it's a terrible thing to see the U.S. House of Representatives, which should be working with this president on behalf of their constituents.
Wouldn't that be nice?
Right.
Yeah.
That they're wasting time and effort that should be going to passing trade agreements, to building infrastructure, to providing the kinds of things, the kinds of initiatives that both parties could work
right.
on.
Right. Well, and things that will benefit the American people.
Absolutely.
After all, that is why people are elected to these positions.
Yes.
It is a bit of a slippery slope, though, and I don't know that the Democrats, Nan, have fully thought this through.
Right.
Because now the standard is so low for impeachment, or for at least calling for an impeachment inquiry.
Absolutely.
Aren't they afraid in some way that this could happen to a future president, perhaps a Democratic president? I mean, what is their thought process here?
Well, Laura, it's hard to figure out. And
you
are stating this from a rational and wise perspective.
Well, I appreciate that.
They are pursuing, and well, it's the truth.
Yeah.
And they, unfortunately, are pursuing this as essentially the ultimate in cancel culture.
Right.
And this has become the way that they view, it's a terrible thing to say this, Laura, but this is the way they view our country. Certainly this is the way the Democratic majority views our country. But having served from a swing district, I know that swing district Democrats who were elected in districts that support President Trump, rightly so, are clearly having second thoughts, as they should have had all along, because as this show trial of witnesses, this parade of witnesses who had nothing to say in regard to what would actually be an impeachable issue.
Of course.
Have proven to be, completely unimpressive to the American public, rightly so. This president has done nothing but dedicate himself to serving this public, and he deserves a Congress that will do the same thing.
I think people see this very clearly, and I think they realize that this is not how our country should be run. This
right.
is not why the impeachment process exists. It is
right.
not to try and oust a duly elected president that
right.
you disagreed with because
right.
your candidate did not win.
Exactly.
Yet that is what they're doing right now.
Oh, absolutely.
And it's funny because we know that the president is very happy to opine on things and give
yes.
his right. voice to
right.
things, Nan.
He's forthright. Isn't it refreshing?
He is very forthright. And
yeah.
it is refreshing,
it
I
is
think,
refreshing.
To people. He, as you can imagine, had a little something to say about this hoax. Take a look at this.
It's a hoax. It's a disgrace. It's an embarrassment to our country. Nancy Pelosi has done a terrible job as speaker. There's never been a speaker that's done so little. And she's totally incompetent. And Shifty Shift, he stands up and he tells lies all day long. And even with that, so we have no due process. We can't have anything. And yet, not only did we win today, it's over.
Nan, what do you think? Do you think most Americans agree with the president there?
Absolutely. The polling is clearly showing that, Laura. And you can't conclude anything else. And wonderful that the president has been so steadfast and that he's had some really terrific support on these House committees.
Yes, absolutely.
And the Republicans have done a great job of making sure that everybody in the American public who's paying any amount of attention understands what a sham this is.
Right.
And the president deserves and should have the support of Congress in moving forward. That's what we did, Laura, when I was from a swing district in the Republican majority with a Democratic president.
Yeah.
We didn't decide we were going to negate the results of the election. We were going to subvert constitutional process so solemnly.
You mean you wanted to do things properly?
Exactly.
Yes.
Exactly. And move ahead for the American people. And we did. We did, Laura. And President Trump stands ready to do that. That is the terrible shame of this. And he's absolutely right. I think that's why you're seeing swing district Democrats Jeff Van Drew in New Jersey saying, you know, I'm not going to vote in favor of this.
Right.
Because he hears his constituents. These members of Congress respond to their constituents.
That's right. They
and
should.
They're hearing it across the country right now.
Well, I want to talk to you about health care. Mm. Many people probably know that you were a member of Congress. Yeah. You're also an ophthalmologist. You're a doctor.
Yes.
And you recently wrote an op-ed titled Health Care Powered by Diversity and Individuality. Yeah. Makes America great. Tell me about that.
And this is President Trump's theme. You know, none of us is exactly like anyone else, even if you have an identical twin.
That's right.
We're all individuals. That's one of the most beautiful aspects of this country, is that this country was founded to put the individual in control as much as possible of our own fate, of our own lives. And healthcare is a perfect example of where it's so important to have the kind of choice and competition and innovation that government action almost always tends to stifle and distort and deny.
Yeah.
You know, I worked in the VA, Laura, and that's the closest thing we've got to government-controlled healthcare. Everybody in this country knows very painfully, and the president's done a lot to help our veterans, including VA Choice, which actually allows them to get care outside the VA, which tells you all you need to know about government-controlled health care. It's government that can say no.
Yeah.
So what this president has done with the Republican majorities in Congress when they passed the Tax Cuts and Jobs Act and eliminated the individual mandate, why should you have to pay an excessive price the government sets for your insurance thanks to the mandates of Obamacare?
Absolutely.
Right? You know, so they've relieved that burden on the American public. The American public has saved $26 billion on generics in the first 18 months of the president's administration alone.
You never hear about these things.
No, that's right.
It's really incredible. You never hear about them. And the president has been very clear. He really wants to get something done on healthcare. I think we could have seen something happen early on in his in his tenure as president,
but for one vote, unfortunately.
But he's still very focused on it, and it's something that he cares greatly about.
Right.
And I think so many people would be very interested to get your take there. They should check out your op-ed. I think it was really. It's really nice to know that you support the president and pointing out things like that that I think oftentimes are forgotten or go unnoticed. And this president is one that no matter if we're talking about healthcare or infrastructure or building the wall, these are things he's focused on. We want to see him happen, but we've got to have four more years of Donald Trump,
We have to have four more years, and that's why I'm side by side with you, Laura. I'm very grateful for your voice.
Oh, thank you so much.
In all of this, because we are all pulling together for
American
people.
You got it right.
That's what President Trump is all about. And you know what? People know that. That's why his support is growing in corners where the Democrats are getting very anxious.
Oh, they're freaking out.
That's right.
Yeah, they're losing their minds over it, but that's okay. Listen, although I always say it, we feel great. We're going to, about 2020, we're going to fight every single day until the president is reelected.
Absolutely.
And we love, Nan, to have you on our team. So thank you for everything you do, and thank you for joining us here today.
Thank you, Laura. Anytime.
The Democrats are abusing what should be a solemn power, but this hoax will backfire on them in 2020. That's the real news for today. If you'd like to get involved with Team Trump, go to DonaldJTrump.com or text Trump to 88022 to join our winning team. I'm Laura Trump from Studio 45 at Trump Tower in New York City. Thanks for joining us, everybody.